In the first video, we covered the general techniques and theory behind topology by taking a close look at how the elbow deforms. As the elbow only bends in one direction, it was easier to show the basic principles along with what topology can't fix. But now that we have the elbow worked out, does this mean it can just be applied to any joint which moves the same, like the knee or fingers? Let's find out, and also consider the best way to plan your topology for an animated character. Looking at a finger bending that uses much the same general topology as the elbow, and it deforms okay-ish. It's not fantastic from either the side or top view, but it gets the job done. However, with a few basic changes, it is possible to have a finger which looks way better from the side and even from a top view. The key here is that any topology needs to consider both function and form in a rest pose as well as during any deformation. With a good mesh foundation, it is then possible to add more detail or make the finger more bony while still deforming correctly. Let's jump on over to the knee, and in this case we start to see topology that is much like the elbow. In many ways, the knee is mostly just a larger version with the mesh a bit more simplified for the kneecap. Keep in mind that just like the elbow, topology isn't doing all the work here. If we turn off preserve volume and the corrective smooth modifier, the back of the knee collapses in. So don't think that moving vertices or adding edge loops will fix everything. Now I'm sure by this point you are all thinking, "That's great, but how do I start?" Depending on the character and the final goal, there's a few options. You could search and download 3D scans of what to model, or look into photogrammetry to create your own. Then there is the fairly standard workflow of sculpting the character first. Or you can download asset bundles, like the free one from Blender. Which reference source you use isn't important. But the next step is, using Blender's built-in annotate tool, with placement set to surface, it's possible to quickly draw out the topology. This way, you can plan out where the edge loops need to go, consider the best place for any poles that change the surface direction, making sure to align polygons with any significant changes in form, while the whole time keeping in mind the general principles of how the topology will deform during animation. Don't expect to get it right on the first try. Here's an initial pass for the shoulder area, which even with some erasing and redrawing, still has a few issues. So based on that, a whole second pass was done. Now things are looking much better, with overall edge flows and placement of poles. It is also easier to just draw a line and erase if required, compared to trying to both plan and create the topology at the same time using polygons. Let's have a look at the face. The best place to start are with markers for the main pole locations where edge loops meet. Then, draw in the eye loops, the mouth loops, and connect it all to the nose. Depending on the character design and the level of animation control required, this is the time to consider the number of points around the eye and mouth. While more can result in better deformation and control, it will also make the overall mesh denser. Once again, with the general layout established, a second plan is sketched out. Now modeling is just a simple case of adding and extruding each polygon without having to figure it all out or discover halfway through that things don't match up. Give or take some minor tweaks, here is what the final mesh looks like. Overall, it follows the topology plan and results in all quads that flow along the main shapes and forms while deforming nicely in pose tests. But of course, as already has been shown, topology isn't everything. In the next video, we will start to have a look at rigging and the impact this can have on exactly how well a model will deform. So make sure to subscribe and hit like so you don't miss out on the next character creation installment, and I hope to see you then. Cheers.